make sure I'm right about this. Yes, good, we are. There is still no word of any kind of significant deal to avoid a government shutdown this Friday. The members of the conservative House Freedom Caucus are not on board for a short-term spending bill that would keep the government running. Why? What's the holdup? What do they want? Well, there's a lot of spin. But what is the truth? We know that hardliners are driving the resistance on the left and the right, including my next guest. Let's go one-on-one with Republican Congressman Jim Jordan of Ohio, who helped found the Freedom Caucus and was its first chairman. Congressman, always a pleasure.
Always good to be with you too, Chris.
So, I see that you're faking some kind of malady, thinking that this will go better for you.
No, I'm not faking. I got laryngitis. I sound like some teenager, but because it's your show, I said I'm still going to come on.
I appreciate it, and I'm sure you stripped your throat arguing for what you want in this bill. I know how passionate you are. Are you in a position right now to vote yes on what's out there for a budget resolution on Friday?
No. Here's what I want. I want us to do what we told the American people we were going to do, what they elected us to do, fund defense, hold the line on non-defense, and do what the election was about on immigration, build the border security wall, end the visa lottery, end chain migration. And then, if the Democrats want to shut down the government because they want to give amnesty to people who came here illegally, then you can have them on your show and they can explain why that's the appropriate thing to do. I don't think it is. That's what this is about, and that's what we in the Freedom Caucus are pushing for.
Where's your heart, though, Congressman? You know the Dreamers are in a fix. You know these aren't your typical illegals, as you guys like to call them. You know the story of the man who was just separated from his family in Detroit. That's not what we're supposed to be about. You heard the president say he wants a bill of love for the Dreamers. Where's your love?
We have love for the rule of law, so let's do things that we campaigned on and the American people elected us to do. So let's do those first, then we can deal with the DACA situation. But the election wasn't so much about DACA, but it was definitely about a border security wall, about chain migration, about the visa lottery, about E-Verify, about sanctuary cities, all those important issues. Those were front and center, particularly in Pennsylvania, Ohio, Michigan, and Wisconsin, states that put Donald Trump in the White House.
But priorities matter here, too, in terms of timing. And when it comes to the wall, look, they're trying to do it delicately for this White House. But, you know, you had Kellyanne say, well, since becoming president, the president has met with experts and understands now that there are geographical restrictions and there are rivers involved. And John Kelly, the general chief of staff, just said, well, he was uninformed. The wall was puffing. I'm going to build a brand new wall along the border. That was a campaign promise. It wasn't something he thought was practical or he should not have thought was practical. Why push for something like that that is not even what the border agents say will make the biggest difference for them?
Chris, it was central to the campaign. Every time the president talked, he talked about border security and a border security wall.
I know, but it was a myth that he was advancing, that this big wall could be built.
I don't think so, and it certainly wasn't a myth with people who voted for
him. His own chief of staff says he was uninformed
at the time. Put the wall where it's appropriate to put the wall, in chain migration, deal with the sanctuary city issue, get rid of the visa lottery. Those are all critical things. And frankly,
but the timing isn't as critical, Jim.
The
timing's not as critical as it is for the Dreamers. People are losing their eligibility day by day.
The court just ruled, Chris. There's no hard deadline now for the DACA individuals.
That's to continue processing applications. You're still getting expirations. That creates anxiety and uncertainty.
There is time to do what the election was about, do what we all campaigned on. There's a reason the American people put Republicans in control of the House, the Senate, and a big reason why they made Donald Trump the president of this great country. So let's focus on those issues, and then we can deal with. And there's a bill, the Labrador piece of legislation that the president has endorsed. That piece of legislation does everything I just described, and it also deals with these 700,000 DACA people, DACA individuals across the country. It deals with them as well. So that's the kind of legislation we should pass, and pass as quickly as we can in the House of Representatives.
If the government shuts down, it's on you, true or false?
No, it's on the Democrats.
We control both houses in the White House.
We can pass something in the House. If it goes over to the Senate, and because of this crazy filibuster rule, this crazy 60-vote rule, Chuck Schumer and Democrats say, amnesty is more important than giving our troops a pay raise. Amnesty is more important than funding our military, getting the weapon systems upgraded, the maintenance done on our vehicles and our ships that needs to be done. If the Democrats say it's more important to have amnesty than to deal with our military at the levels we all know it needs to be, frankly, at levels even most Democrats have already voted for, then that's on them, and you have to have them on your show and ask them the question, why are they shutting down the government?
I can guarantee you that I will. That's what we do.
Good.
But I don't know that that's the fair proposition. First of all, let's not be too heavy-handed about where you guys on the right are when it comes to military spending. You know, sequestration was something that a lot of your brothers and sisters were in favor of,
too. I didn't vote for it.
And that put a sledgehammer onto the military
budget. And I didn't vote for it.
But it was front-run by your side, right?
Well, yeah, but I didn't vote for it. And we're on record in the House this year, the vast majority of Republicans and a majority of Democrats supporting the National Defense Authorization Act, which authorizes spending at certain levels. So Democrats can't have it both ways. They can't vote for the authorization, and then when it comes time to actually fund our troops and pay for our military, say, oh, I'm not going to vote for it because I think amnesty is more important. Really? That's your position? I'm not going to vote for
it, even though I voted for it before. That's deceptive, calling it amnesty, because...
Did they come here legally? I mean, that's, look, we want to help these individuals.
Can a 10-year-old form criminal intent?
Well, what I'm saying is, did they come here legally?
Can a 10-year-old form criminal intent?
Can a 10-year-old come here illegally through their parents?
They can be brought here illegally, but they can't commit a crime.
That's why they're defined as...
And that's the point. Their innocence.
That's why they're talked about childhood arrivals, and I understand that, and we want to help those individuals.
Not really, you don't want to. You're putting them at the end of this laundry list of, like, every other thing that you want first. They're not your priority.
The Good Labrador Bill deals with the DACA individuals in the appropriate way, but it says while you're doing that and before you do that, secure the border, which was fundamentally the focus of the 2016 election.
But was that done on a good faith basis? You don't think that there was an effort during the election to make people who come in here illegally monsters? This report came out from DHS.
How do you explain
this report, Congressman?
We're the greatest country in the world. We welcome people from everywhere.
But you're making it sound like they have a 50-50 chance to be terrorists.
They got to do it legally. And what I'm saying is, when we're going to deal with these individuals who came here as children, we need to do it in a way that is consistent with the campaign and consistent with securing our border.
But those are campaign promises that are now being pulled back by people in the White House themselves, and maybe with good reason.
I think we should keep our promise. I think we should keep our word.
I understand.
I think the voters expect that as well, so let's do it, and let's take care of these individuals who came here, but let's do it in that order.
We'll end on this. Of all the things that we've been discussing here in terms of what people want, nothing polls higher than... Save these people who are the dreamers. Save these people. They don't deserve to get thrown out. Even within your own party, 3 out of 4 Republicans say, do them the right way.
And we're not against that, but we're for securing the border first.
But that's not what happens in the polls. So priorities matter. Those are the choices. And as always, you'll be judged at the polls. But Congressman, thank you. I know you're not 100%, but you're always more than I can handle. Thank you for being with me on the show.
You bet, Chris. Thanks for having me.